Many of the 3D objects in Chief Architect have dynamic automatic labels, like doors, windows, and cabinets. These labels are dynamic, meaning that they will automatically change if I edit the object. If I double-click on one of these windows to open the Window Specification dialog, you can see here on the left side the Label panel. Most objects in Chief have this label option. Here in the label information, you can see that these windows are using automatic labels. That displays the width, height, and the window type. But we have the option to specify the label here. We can just type in text as we want it to show in the plan view. But notice, when I click OK to close this dialog, that when I use the edit handles to change the size of this window, the label does not change. It is not dynamic. It is static because it is simple text. Instead, we can use macros in our labels. Text macros insert dynamic information relative to the selected object. Dynamic means that it will change automatically when the object is edited. Macros can be used to create customized object labels. To add a macro into this window label, go to the Insert Macro button and down to Object Specific. Here we can add the width, type in X, and then add the height. We can also add the type code. You can see here in the preview pane what that will look like in a plan view. Now, when I click OK, you can see when I use the edit handles to change the width that the number in the label is changing with it. If I open the Window Specification dialog and change the window type, the type here in the label also changes automatically. Like other objects, you can customize your room labels as well. Room labels already have the option for showing information about each room already embedded in them. Here in the active layer display, you can see that each room has layers that you can display for the interior room area, interior dimensions of the room, and/or the standard area of each room. You can simply turn any of these on with layers. If you turn off the main room labels layer, it will turn off all of these layers at the same time. But let's say I want to add ceiling height to my room labels. If I open this room label here, you can see that there is no way to edit the label text. You will need to change the room label defaults. So we'll go up here to the default settings, go to floors and rooms, and down here to room label. And here under text, we have the option to add text or macros. Go to Insert Macros, and under the global category under room info, I'll add room ceiling height. When I click OK, you will notice that the existing room labels did not change in the plan. But if you open the Room Specification dialog, uncheck Show Room Label, and then check it again, and then click OK, the room label will refresh, and now you can see the new information appear. As you can see, the new information is added on the same line as the room name. I want it on the line under the room name. So, back in the Room Label Defaults, I will put a line return in front of this macro. And, because the macro is generating a simple number value, I also want to add some additional information. So I'll type in ceiling height, and AFF, above finished floor, then click OK. Refresh the room labels. And now we can see the added information in the labels. All new room labels will include this information as well, and any changes to the room will automatically reflect in the room label. The new label information will be in the same text style, size, and color as the room name, and it will also be on the same layer. So unlike the room dimensions and area label options, you can either display both or neither using the Room Labels layer.